Yes, good evening everyone.
Good evening, sir.
Okay. So, any doubt from the question paper?
No doubt, sir.
Turn on your cameras, everyone. Okay, so today we are going to start with a new chapter. We did not start, right? So, actually it's been more than a month since we started, you know, lines and angles. So, let us go with our syllabus somewhat quicker and quicker. So yes, so tell me which chapter you want me to start today.
So chapter 7.
So
that's triangles.
Yeah,
yes, the triangles.
Yes, the triangles.
Okay. One second. Someone has texted me. Who is that?
Sir, 1 minute, sir. I need to get my book.
One second.
Sir, are you doing triangle and its angle?
So, next triangles, let us go with the triangles. Okay. All right. Yes, can you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yes. Now, triangles. Let us talk about triangles, guys. So basically, from the triangles, what are the things you have learned, guys? Tell me any thing which
triangles some property. The property of exterior angle, right? The measure of exterior angle is equal to the measure of opposite interior angle.
Scallion triangle, isosceles, and
equilateral. Okay, what else?
Means type of test, means SAS test and SS test, like that.
Okay, how many have you done with this chapter in your school, from your school?
Sir, I have done.
Sir, it's done for me.
Okay.
Sir, it is done for me also.
Okay, how many of you have done with this?
Sorry, sir.
Sir, it's done for me.
How many have you done with this chapter in your
school? It's done for me, sir.
Not for me, sir.
Okay. Okay. So how many of you will do that? Okay. Chalo. Yes, so let us talk about first one by one. Let us talk about these all triangles.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, guys, so from the triangles, so what are the things you guys have learned first? First, tell me what do you mean by triangle. So let us talk about what is triangle, what are the congruence of triangles, so what are the criteria of congruence of a triangle. Let us talk about that. Next, we'll talk about properties of triangle. All right. So then inequalities of triangles. So these are the major five topics which you need to focus on from the triangles lesson. All right, what are they? The first topic is what? What do you mean by the definition of triangle? Second one is what? Congruence of triangle. Congruence of triangle is what? So what do you mean by congruence of triangle? Make it fast.
Equal means equal angle.
Oh. Congruence of triangle. Then criteria. What are the criteria we have under congruence?
So,
we have
SAS.
So SAS, SSS, ASA, and AS.
So we have properties of triangle. What
and hypotenuse side test also.
And sir, RHS also.
RHS also.
RHS.
What are the properties of triangles you have learned?
Sir, this much.
Sir, the sum of all angles of
a triangle. Exterior angle property.
Sir, I have.
So angle sum property and exterior angle property.
Sir, I have
and learned. All the sum of all the exterior angles is 360 degrees.
Mm-hmm. Sum of all the
exterior angle is 360.
Sir, I have learned remote angles theorem also.
Okay, look at this. So first, let us talk about triangle definition. What do you mean by triangle?
A plane figure.
A closed figure formed by three intersecting lines. So there is a one line, two lines, three lines. These three intersecting lines are framing a figure called triangle. As simple as that. Look at this. You understand? Yes, let me write it clearly. Let me write it. So first, let us draw a diagram. Let us say, okay, this is a triangle. This is A, B, C. So three intersecting lines framing a closed figure. You write like A. Closed figure. A closed figure formed by three intersecting lines is called a triangle. All right, basically, what do you mean by try? Try means what?
So three.
All right, try means three. Basically, a triangle has, everyone writes, a triangle has three sides and three angles and three vertices. What do you mean by vertices here? So these are what is available. So these are three sides, AB, BC, and CA. So these are the three sides which I have in triangles. And three angles. What are angle A, angle B, angle C? And three vertices means A, B, C. All right. So this is the basic information of triangle. So look at this now. What could you write here? What are the things you can write here? So from the triangle, in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, it's denoted as how? This is how I'm going to denote this triangle, small triangle as a triangle ABC. All right, so here. AB, BC, CA are the three sides. What are they? They are three sides. Now here angle A, comma angle B, comma angle C are the three angles and A comma B comma C are three vertices. All right. Any doubts about this information? Very simple information and very, you know, cool information.
No, sir. No doubt.
chalo. So understood, guys. What do you mean by this? Sides. These are the vertices. Okay, there's a B, a C, and A. These are the three vertices. All right. Chalo. Next, we'll talk about. So, what are the congruence of triangle? What do you mean by congruence of triangle?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So, can you please roll up once?
Yes.
Sir, do we just put the heading as triangle?
Basically, we have learned that triangle. Triangle means what? So, we need basic information to, you know, start with our basic questions, right? So that's why. Done.
Yes, sir.
1 second, someone is calling.
You can hear me.
Yes, Sushant, sir, is on call.
Yes, you can hear me now.
Yes.
Yes. Guys, if you are late, I'm not going to admit anyone actually. So, and you are late and you are calling.
Actually, again, sir. Again, I read.
See here, you are calling in between the class. That is not the case. Actually, don't be like that. So, please be on time. All right. So, what are the congruence of triangles? What do you mean by congruence of triangle? Look at this. Let us write that.
Sir, if all three sides and all three angles of a triangle is equal to the all three sides and all three angles of another triangle.
Yes.
Then the triangles are said to be congruent.
Yes. So, first, suppose you said two triangles are congruent. Two triangles are congruent. When would you say if the sides? The sides and angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides, equal to the corresponding sides and angles of the other triangle. All right. So what do you understand from, what did you understand from these two triangles are congruent? When would you say it's congruent? If the sides and angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and angles of other triangle, then only I can say that these two triangles are congruent. Clear? All right. Let us draw two triangles here. So first of all, there's a P at angle Q, here R. All right, P, Q, R. I have two triangles. Let us say this is A, B, C. A, B, C. All right. So these are the two triangles. Two triangles here. Now, when can I say this? When can I say that these two triangles are congruent? Tell me. So first, look at this.
But the angles are same.
For example,
R is congruent to ABC. If triangle PQR is congruent to triangle ABC, then how do we write this? We write that angle. So first triangle PQR is equal to triangle ABC, isn't it? So these two triangles.
Sir, happen. But congruent we write means. Two equal and one
yes. Super yes, here look at this. P is supposed to be equal to this P. This Q is supposed to be equal to this B. This R is supposed to be equal to this R. And here QR is supposed to be equal to BC. Here PQ is supposed to be AB. And PR is supposed to be AC. I mean CR. So corresponding angles and sides supposed to be equal. That is a basic concept here. All right. Any doubts?
Sir, you told it is equal or congruent.
No. See, yes. What I told, look at this, sir. I did not tell equal. You just try to look at the definition. Two triangles are congruent with the sides. Their angles of one triangle. Look at this side and their angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides of another angle. Corresponding sides and angles of another triangle. That is what I told here. Look at this here. You understand? So here, sides of one triangle, which means PQ, sides of this side.
PQ, but the symbol of congruent is different, right? It is not.
This is the symbol. Look at this. I can just denote like this. PQR. PQR is similar to ABC. All right. You just listen to me. I'll tell you. Okay. Please don't be hurry. All right, beta. Chalo, look at this here. Now I could say that here. PQ is equal to AB. If this PQR is congruent to ABC, then what can I write? So PQ is equal to AB. QR is equal to BC. AC is equal to, or you write with PR. So PR is equal to AC. All right. So whenever I'm satisfying with these conditions, so I could say that triangle PQR and triangle ABC are congruent to each other. All right. You understand? So when could I say the congruent? So if and only if sides, I mean corresponding sides and angles of two triangles equal to each other, then only I could say that two triangles are congruent to each other. I hope it is clear with everyone. There is nothing like a big rocket science subject. Very simple subject.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Very simple. Clear? Shall we go for next point?
Yes, sir.
Shall we go for next point?
Yes, sir, you can.
So everyone write note here, note. Not everyone write a note here.
But the congruent symbol is different, right? Not equal to.
This one.
Yes, sir.
I wrote it. Oh, you are talking, sir, about this one.
Two equal and then.
You are talking about this one.
Yes, sir. This
You are talking about this one. I thought like you are talking.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, of course. That is what I told, right? That is what I told you now.
So the which one you draw, that is similar triangle.
Good. So before that, yes, someone was asking, who's that Kaji? Kaji was asked. I told this one symbol, but I didn't write over there. That is what you're talking about. Now I got it.
Yes, sir.
Chalo, let us write a note now. Note. See here, note. If you talk about note here, the note is basic, very important note. Everyone try to write this. Congruent triangles. Congruent triangles, corresponding parts. Congruent triangles, corresponding parts are equal. Corresponding parts are what? Equal, isn't it? Equal. And we write or denote in short form. That as CPCT. For what do you mean by CPCT here?
Congruent part of a congruent triangle.
Corresponding parts of.
So it's corresponding pairs of congruent triangle, isn't it?
Corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Yes. See here, Toshnika, you said that corresponding pairs. What do you mean? Look at this one and this one, which means here PQ and AB are what? These are two sides. They are a pair, isn't it?
Yes.
That you can just understand like that. All right, beta. Yeah. चलो नाउ व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट यू नो पैरामीटर्स वी हैव व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट क्राइटेरियाज वी हैव अंडर दिस कॉन्ग्रुएंट ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स बेसिकली जस्ट नो यू नो मेनी ऑफ यू सेड दैट यू नो देयर इज नथिंग मच टू रीड अबाउट देयर इज अ वेरी सिंपल कांसेप्ट वेरी सिंपल सा फंडा ज्यादा सीखने का ज्यादा कोई हम लोग इधर रिसर्च करने का जरूरत नहीं है बहुत सिंपल सा कांसेप्ट है बस अंडरस्टैंड करो बस ठीक है अंडरस्टैंड करो कोई ने याद रखने का जरूरत नहीं है no one should remember anything here everyone should visualize the how we are drawing it and how you are you know learning it out clear chalo now let us talk about now criteria what are the criteria we have criteria for congruence of triangle guys if I write like this what do you mean by like this if I write this is you understand this is a triangle In short way, I'm writing like that. Clear, children? You understand if I write like this, you just understand that as a triangle. If you want to write in your note, you write it as a full. But I'm writing in a shortcut for saving our time. All right. So what are the criteria you told, guys? First, the first criteria is SA is congruent. Yes.
Side angle, side cut.
No one should talk, please. If I ask you, you must tell me that. Don't talk in between. Okay, please, children. Congruence rule. What do you mean by SAS rule? SAS rule in what do you mean by SAS? SAS rule means basically.
Sir, SAS criteria is you know if two sides
Bhargav,
and the angle.
Bhargav, are you? Who is that? Is it Bhargav?
Yes, sir.
Just now I said please until and unless ask. Until I unless ask, please keep quiet and please try to listen to me carefully. Please don't interrupt in between. I request you all. All right.
So can you roll it a little up?
Look at this. Ha, guys, please everyone try to listen to the class first of all. You know, listen to the class carefully. Listen to the class carefully. Show your intensity towards the screen as well as copying. Not at a time. Not you should not only copy. You should not only listen. You should do at a time. As I told earlier as well. Yes, chalo beta. Look at this. SAS congruence rule. SAS congruence rule. What do you mean by SAS rule? See, let me tell you. Two triangles are congruent. If two sides, two sides and the angle of one triangle are equal to the sides and included angle of another triangle you write here included angle Sides.
Shouldn't we mention the two sides for other angle also?
Yes, you can mention like that. I'm writing in my own way. You can just under two sides and included angle. You write like this, included angle. And included angle of another. All right.
Sir, I did not understand this part. Included of one triangle.
See, you just leave all this if you are not understand. Let me write in a simplest way. आपको ये नहीं समझ में आ रहा तो छोड़ो इसको. ठीक है? Look at this. कोई ना देखो, कुछ भी देखो. See here, what is a kind of axiom. You know, it's a kind of axiom. All right. चलो देख, हम लोग फिर से लिखते हैं. आपको नहीं समझ में आ रहा है. So कोई ले लो, कोई two triangles. Simple जब भाषा में लिखेंगे. Two triangles. are congruent if two sides एंड इंक्लूडेड एंगल आप कुछ भी एंगल ले लो इंक्लूडेड ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट इंक्लूडेड एंगल ऑफ वन ट्राइंगल आर इक्वल टू द करेस्पॉन्डिंग इक्वल टू द करेस्पॉन्डिंग साइड्स एंड the included angle of the another triangle. See here, what do you mean by this? Look at this, two triangles are congruent if the two sides and included angle means matlab jo bhi include jo bhi angles include hua hai udhar. So what are the angles which are included over there? That is what included angle of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and included angle of the other triangle. ये होता है हमारा ACS rule. All right. So we are talking about here two sides and one angle. ACS means two sides and angle. One angle here. We are talking about one angle, isn't it? So that's what I'm saying here. So two triangles are congruent if the two sides are included. Two sides and included angle of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and included angle of the other triangle. Understand? You understand, children?
Yes, sir. Yes,
two sir. Sides of two sides and one angle yes, of one triangle is equal to two sides of and one angle of another triangle is supposed to be equal. That is what ACS rule. All right. Chalo, now let us talk about.
Sir, can you take an example of the ACS congruence rule?
Sorry.
Can you give an example?
Can you please take an example for the ACS congruence rule?
Yes, definitely. You write anything. Look at here. You write. You draw just. Let us draw again the same triangle which we have done here. So let us say that A, B, C. All right. And let us draw triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Okay. So look at this here. If I just talk about two sides, which are they look at the corresponding side, this one, this blue color, you understand? This one, these two sides, it's a one side, so one side, and the next side is I'm talking about this one, this green color and green color. All right, so two corresponding sides, I'm an angle, I'm talking about this angle, which angle? This one, angle B, if I talk about this one. I'm talking about this angle. All right. Chalo, look at this here. Here. Here, guys, look at this. I'm just talking. Whenever AB and PQ. AB is equal to PQ and BC is equal to QR and angle B is equal to angle Q. Then that is going to call as what? That is then I could say that ABC and PQR triangles are following ACS congruence rule. You understand, children?
Yes, sir. I understand.
Yes. Sir, ACS
means
side angle side.
Look at this here. This side angle. Understand?
Yes,
sir. Sir, in this term, we consider angle C and angle R. Yes, of course. Why not? Look at
because
here.
Because it is not between line PQ and QR.
Yes, look at this. Now, for whenever you are considering R and C, then you must say that AC and PR and angle R, angle C, then QR and BC. Then you must change your sides. You understand?
So the angle between the two lines must be in consideration.
Yes, that is what I'm telling. Look at this here. Here, if I talk about this one, A, B, C, P, Q, R, I said, right? Now, if I take this one, A, C, P, R, these are corresponding. All right. So that's supposed to be equal. And this angle R and C supposed to be equal. And B, C and Q are supposed to be equal. All right. So that follows then congruence. All right, beta.
Understood.
Hello. Now you know we have highlighted with the green and we have highlighted with this thing. So please, usko thoda samjhiye. Make it fast. So, shall we go for the next one? The next one is what? The next one I'm just going to talk about. Triple S congruence rule. ये तो सबसे इजी है. ऑलराइट. हां टेल मी व्हाट डू यू मीन.
इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड सर.
ऑल द साइड्स आर इक्वल.
एनीवन आई एम गिविंग अ चांस टू भार्गव. नाउ भार्गव विल एक्सप्लेन मी दिस. भार्गव वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट समथिंग सो ही विल एक्सप्लेन नाउ. यस भार्गव.
सर आई शैल एक्सप्लेन एसएसएस कॉन्ग्रुएंसी रूल
राइट.
यस. सो एसएसएस कॉन्ग्रुएंसी रूल. इन एसएसएस कॉन्ग्रुएंसी रूल इफ all the three sides of one triangle is equal to the all the three sides of the other triangle, then then both the triangles are said to be congruent.
Great. So if three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, you write in the word, sorry, another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. All right, then the two triangles are what? Congruent. So look at this here. Three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another. So then we can say the two triangles are congruent. Chalo, abhi dekhenge isko.
So Harini is in waiting room, sir. She just texted me to ask you to let her in.
Yes. Okay. Look at this. If all sides are exactly, if all sides are exactly the same, then their corresponding angles must also be exactly the same. Look at this here. All sides are exactly like same. Okay. Or exactly all sides are exactly the same. So then the corresponding angles must be exactly the same. Whenever talking about same angles, all same angles, then angles also must be same. All right. All sides exactly same means then their corresponding angles also must be exactly the same. All right, children. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Chalo. Now let us talk about ASA. So look at this. Same thing. You can just compare the same example for the SSS triple S congruence rule as well. So guys, now let us talk about ASA. What do you mean by ASA? Look, for this let me give an example. Look at this. Koi triangle le lo aisa. Dekho, A, B, C, P, Q, R. Theek hai? So here, look at this. A, B is supposed to be this A, B, P, Q. All right. Isko aisa maar lo. Here, B, C supposed to be equal to Q, R. All right. Now, A, C. This A, C is supposed to be equal to P, R. All right. This is what the diagram for that.
Okay, sir.
Next, A congruence. Congruence rule. So here basically we'll talk about two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the another triangle. Look at this here. So two triangles are congruent if two angles and included side, one side, right? Of one triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and the included side of the another triangle. That is what A congruence rule. So let me talk about example here. Right. Look at, let us say A, B, C, sorry, P. PQR. All right, one second, guys. Yes, look at this. So if I have two triangles ABC and PQR, so let us say that angle B kuch bhi le lo. Let us say angle B is 30 degrees. If angle B is 30 degrees, the corresponding angle of PQR triangle is what? Q also must be 30 degrees. If angle C is somewhere 90 degrees, or let us say 90, that's 80 degrees. Then angle R also must be what? 80 degrees. All right, samaj? Aya? Samaj aya? And look at this now. And you are talking about angle, side angle, right? So angle 30, B is 30. Side, which side? I'm talking about BC. Let us say this is koi 5 centimeter hai. To ye bhi kya hona chahiye? 5 centimeter hona chahiye. Aya, samaj? Koi doubt, beta? Dekho, angle. This angle, side, angle. I ask much. Quid out?
No doubt, sir.
Very simple. Koi kitna. Arey baba, dekho baba. Utna jada socho mat. Kuch nahi hai udhar. Dekho idhar naam mein hi hai. Idhar in the name itself we have everything. A. Angle side. Angle. Bas utna yaad rakho bas. Chalo. Next. Let us go with the. Double A S. I mean angle side. Yes. Who was asking? Who was calling? Someone was calling. Who's that?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, someone was calling. Who's that?
No idea, sir. That's
all. Okay, no problem. So AAS. Okay, this is what it is. So if I talk about two triangles are said to be congruent. to each other, congruent to each other, if two angles, if two angles and one side.
This is A is congruent. Already we done sir AS.
A is already done.
Sir, AS is done, not A.
AS is done. Okay, A also one congruent.
Two triangles are said to be congruent if we each congruent to each other. If two angles and one side of one triangle. Side of
AAS and AS are the same thing.
Double A. No. Look at this here. AASA is different and AAS is different. You already, guys.
Here, sir, isn't it both of them have the same thing? Both of them have two angles and a side in common.
Where you told? I didn't get you. We have discussed AASA. So you mean that AAS and AASA, you are talking about that one?
Yes, sir.
No, the order. I'm talking about order. Here, angle, side, angle. Here, angle, angle, side. You understand? See here, we are talking about here. If I say that angle, side, angle, angle, side, angle. Here, that is not the case here. Here, if I talk about this one and triangle, here I'm talking about angle, angle, and side. Angle, angle, and this side. Like that. All right.
Yes, sir.
So let us look at this here now. So two triangles are said to be congruent to each other. If two angles and one side of one triangle. One triangle are equal to two angle and one side of the another triangle. Tell me here, two angles and a side equal to, so supposed to be equal to two angles and a side of another triangle. All right. So guys, tell me here now. Guys, here we, now if I talk about this, what about this? Here triple A and double ASA. What do you mean by double ASA?
Side angle.
So are they valid to, now can you compare these two, whether they are valid or no? Are you getting anything, any ideas from that? See, what I'm asking is SSA and AAA. These are the two congruency rules, right? So what exactly you understood from this? So angle, congruency rule. What do you mean by angle?
The length can be different, right? So it won't be congruent.
Which one?
Yeah, the AAA.
I'm not saying both are equal. Length, yes, of course, you're right. I'm not saying whether they are equal or not. I'm asking you whether they are valid or not.
Yes, sir. That's why I said they cannot be valid because the length of the sides may differ, even though the angles are same.
Okay. Even the angles are same?
The side length differs.
Side might be different. That is, look at this now here. So in under, one second, guys.
Sir, AAS is a valid sir.
Hey, your staff. Anyone says stop to share message. I joined. I got disconnected and came.
Children, sorry, there is a mic error. Who was talking? Yaar, kya baat kar raha hai? Can you see the screen, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like after this, can we discuss a doubt in question paper? Like, I have a doubt.
Yeah, definitely.
Sir, even I am having doubt.
See, beta, look at this here. Doubt session. As I told you guys, Wednesday. I mean, next class will keep doubt session. Okay. Every Wednesday, you look at this here. Every Wednesday, you have doubt session. every
no,
business.
Sir, I mean like question paper.
But you are not trainer, sir.
No. Every Wednesday, 4 to 5. As I told you that 4 to 5, we have a doubt session. We have fixed with the time actually.
But
yes.
Then for the, we didn't discuss the question paper, right? So
yes, that is what I'm telling you, beta. So that's what, in the first, when I just joined the class, I just asked you whether you have any doubts or not. So you said that no. So that's why I started with the new chapter. Now you are asking for the doubts. So now we have just left with only 4 minutes of time. No issues, Piyush. Definitely 110%, not even 100, 200%.
Okay, sir, no problem.
Okay, Piyush, discuss. We'll discuss. No problem, beta. Yes, tell me. We are in between this side. I cannot stop in half of this lesson. I cannot go for the doubt separately. So that's why we have just 4 minutes of time. So now.
No quiz today.
Beta, quiz, as I told you, beta, quiz won't be on every day. You also please understand my situation. I cannot conduct everyday quiz. So it is weekly twice is fine. So weekly 3 days is won't fine actually. Why? Because you know, I have to finish the syllabus, right? So if you keep keeping the quizzes and conducting the quiz, you know, it kills our time. Minimum 10 to 15 minutes. I know that, you know, even we consider for 5 minutes, it kills our, you know, 10 to 12 minutes. So that's what. So why? Because we have to finish. As soon as we done with our syllabus, every day we'll write quiz. Let us see how many of you go to that. Every day we'll write quiz. Okay.
So sir, which days we'll have?
So Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yeah, I think Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I think you guys have class.
Sir, but Wednesday you are not free, right?
Yeah. Wednesday I just took a slot from 4 to 5. That's why I'm asking you.
Oh yeah, you can take.
Yeah, 4 to 5. I took a slot for you. Actually, I just made some changes over there. That was the only possibility for taking me. So yeah, that is what I'm.
Sir, one last doubt, sir. Sir, can you keep this class will complete means? Can you keep Google? This notes in Google Classroom after this class, please.
Notes, you mean?
Sir, yes, sir. Always kept note, right?
This notes.
I always post them. Yeah. I think you know.
Sir, we'll post them at 7 o'clock. After this class, you can post.
I every day, man. Every day, I just do that. You, I think you are, yes, not looking after the notes.
Directly sir, after I'm class, sir, post.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Tell me. Okay, so AAS rule we have done. So now let us talk about this. Triple A, what do you mean by triple A congruency rule?
Angle.
Corresponding angles of two triangles supposed to be what? Equal. That's what, isn't it? You write same definition.
Sir, angle exists.
Look at this here. Now that is what I'm about to say.
But A congruency.
This is a not valid test. This is not valid test. Why? Because tell me, any reason?
That the length of sides is not different.
Yes. So two triangles can have all three same angles, and the sides can be differing lengths. The side may be differing, right? The side may be having different lengths. So this, you know, this test. So this becomes now AA, not triple A. All right, this becomes AA now. So as PU said, that is 110% correct. Vivekan, this is not going to be not valid. No, it is not going to be valid actually. Why? Because so even you have the same angles, beta. Even you have same angles, side may be different, right? Side may be different. So there is going to be not valid. You all right? So look at this. Let us say that. Look at this. ABC, and let us say this. Koi bhi le lo. A, B, C, P. Q, R. All right. So if I talk about this, angle A is equal to angle R here. All right. Red color. So angle B is equal to angle C. Let us say that. And angle A is equal to angle P here. Let us say that. Now, guys, your sides are different. Even though you have same angles and the measure of the angle is, you know, measurement of the angles is same, then your sides may be different, right? Sides may be different. So this is going to be not valid. And double A rule. This is also not valid. Why? Tell me. Why? Tell me. So here you write, guys. Here you write. Reason is what? Sides might be different. Sides might be different. All right. Any doubts here? Hello.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Look at this. Now let us talk about this one. So, guys, I'll give a here. Yes, A. Congruency. congruence rule is also not valid. Tell me the reason. Find it out the reason. So, and let us discuss in the next class. And guys, in next class, we have a doubt session.
Sir, on Wednesday.
Yes, next class Wednesday. And this doubt session includes QP discussion. QP discussion means question paper discussion, as well as your class doubts. Okay.
So sir, but this Wednesday, it's festival, right?
What festival?
Eid al-Adha, sir.
Bakrid, sir.
We will see that. Okay, we'll see. I maximum will be having class, though Bakrid and all, we won't be having holidays and all. Okay, so yes.
Could you please keep after 6 or any time, sir?
I'll be having another classes, as I told you. I'll be having another classes.
Sir, keep.
Sir, after 6, I can't get
there. I'll see in the morning, sir.
Ma, actually, I just look after all the timings. So none of the times. So morning, I'll check. You know, let me check with the Manoj sir and let you know. Okay, again. All right.
Yes, sir. Please don't keep it after 6 o'clock. I can't attend.
Yes. So here, you know, many of you cannot attend after 6. Many of you cannot attend in the after 3. Then I'm not sure. Definitely, I'm not aware of when I should keep the class. It is completely disturbing after a lot of discussion. So we just fixed it up to 4 to 5 as a doubt session. So please, all right, chalo beta, hum log abhi jaate hain, I have next class right now, so I have to leave right now, so we'll meet in the next session, then goodbye, thank you, and please everyone try to attend try to attempt your worksheet. I have posted a worksheet, right? Please everyone try to finish that and try to solve all the Sharma problems, and as soon as we're done with the introduction part of this lesson, I'll be posting one more worksheet to you all. Everyone should solve that problems as well as. And we are so much back, syllabus, actually. We have to run like a horse riding. We have to do horse riding now. Isn't it? Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, beta.
Yes.
Nothing, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir. Take care.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.